Ground penetrating radar, GPR, is a geophysical method that uses radar pulses to create images of the subsurface landscape. GPR works by measuring the strength and the time it takes for the reflected pulses to return to the surface. It is an excellent prospection tool to identify buried areas of archaeological interest.
So as we're walking along, the GPR will be sending out the radar waves, electromagnetic energy, into the ground every 2 centimeters as we walk. And then it's going to listen for that energy to be reflected back up to the receiver, to the antenna, and record it. We'll set a time window. We'll tell it how long we want it to listen, and that will determine kind of the maximum depth that we'll be able to see.
In archaeology, GPR is used when further information is needed to help refine the parameters of a site. For example, GPR can assist in locating a buried structure identified through historical mapping or locate unmarked graves. GPR can also be used to produce a more localized survey across discrete features of a site to get a better idea of their size, depth, and other additional information prior to excavation.
The GPR would almost always be a viable instrument to help us understand an archaeological site. Having a longer wavelength or lower megahertz, lower frequency, also allows us to get deep enough for burials. So I do a heap of work in cemeteries, unmarked burials within marked cemeteries, or trying to delineate the boundaries of cemeteries, especially out in rural areas.
These methods can pinpoint the best places to excavate within a survey area and indicate which areas should be avoided. This can be especially useful for large survey areas, where GPR can be used prior to excavation to enhance predictive modeling and build a high-resolution subsurface map.
As one, it helps us get an understanding of potential boundaries for the site. In addition to letting us see sort of the intra-site variability, like where maybe houses are versus pits versus whatever.
Using GPR in archaeological investigations offers a convenient, reliable, and non-destructive method to investigate the subsurface landscape. This streamlines the traditional excavation work of archaeologists by indicating areas of interest before breaking ground, as well as avoiding damage to more modern buried assets such as utility networks.
So, you know, if we were able to see a nice, or what would clearly be a foundation of a building, that also, well, one, that gives us a target for excavation. And we can try to align that with historical data like maps or other information that we know about the property. Maybe try to figure out what the building was used for. But it also gives an indication of what's happened here since abandonment. And if we're not seeing things like foundations or kind of clear spatial layout of the site, it gives us some indication that there might be disturbance that's happened since.
Ultimately, GPR enables more effective project planning to save time, effort, and money for both the archaeologist and their clients, and is considered an accurate, high-resolution geophysical technology.